Chemist Gerhart Friedlander recalls his work on an alternative reactor at Los Alamos located in a canyon below the laboratory. This was the first water boiler, or homogeneous reactor, that used liquid fuel dissolved in a solution rather than solid fuel embedded in graphite blocks. The alternative approach was important to learn more about how an atomic bomb works.
My first major assignment was in connection with the first homogeneous nuclear reactor. There already had been nuclear reactors, the first one at the University of Chicago, which Enrico Fermi built, and then the prototype production reactor had been built at Oak Ridge. The first two reactors were so-called heterogeneous reactors in which uranium rods were embedded in a graphite lattice. The later plutonium production reactors at Hanford were all of that type. What was needed to get vital information for making a bomb was a homogeneous reactor in which the fissionable material, uranium or plutonium, whatever it was homogeneously distributed in the medium, because that's the way a bomb functions. It's a homogeneous medium of only uranium or plutonium. So the way this was done was to use enriched uranium, enriched in U-235, in an aqueous solution. And as a chemist, I and my colleagues had the task of producing this solution, purifying it, analyzing it, and we got the very first samples of enriched U-235 from Oak Ridge. And I remember how my boss came into my lab with this bottle of material and said, "Now, this is the very first sample of enriched uranium anybody has ever handled, and it's worth several million dollars, so please be careful." So indeed, we were very careful, and we didn't lose any, but it wasn't exactly, didn't exactly make us feel very calm and comfortable, so made us nervous. But we did it, we purified the stuff.